Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to customize some cells in your fillable form. So today I'm going to show you how you can restrict the amount of characters and words that your user will place in a cell. So if you go up to the developer tab, now if you don't have the developer tab, if you go to Word, go to Preferences, go to Ribbon and Toolbar, and then on this section here where it says main tabs, make sure the developer tab is checked. Now, if you have a PC, I will link a video below to show you how you can get the developer tab into your software. So go to your developer tab, select the cell where you want some restricted characters to lie. Go to text box and just select a normal text box. Now this text box will allow your user to type the answers to these questions in this box. If you double click on that text box, then this menu will appear. You can go to any of these fields here and change them. So the type of text that you want, whether it's numbers and dates, etc. You can put some default text in there if you want to. But this section here details the maximum length of the text that you'll place into that cell. So if I just push the arrow key, you can see we start with numbering here. Now, I've had a bit of a play around with this, and if I just get rid of this text box, and I just type out all the letters until I get to the end of my cell. Right, so that's too many. So I've got the maximum amount of characters in this cell. If I highlight all of those characters, then I go up to Review and go to Word Count, you can see I've got 57 characters in that cell. So if I go back to the Developer tab, I place in my text box, I double click on it, and I place in here 57, press enter, and now I can test this. So if I just go, make sure I'm on developer, go to protect form. So once you're in the protect form area, it means you can't adjust this field. So what I can do is just type to check if my cell moves. And you can see that it did move on those 57 characters. You can see the form has moved, which is quite irritating because you think, well, I've just put in 57 characters and it shouldn't move. However, if we go back and unprotect the form by clicking protect form again, you know it's unprotected because this is all available to use. If I click this and all of these are grayed out, it means your form is protected. So what we need to do is to double click on here again, go to 57, and I'm going to go down to two characters. So I'm going to do 55, click OK, protect my form, and then test it again. So I'm just going to keep typing, and now it hasn't nudged. So you do need to just fine tune this to ensure that once you put those character limitations in, the form does not move. Now, if you don't want this grayed out shading, once your form is protected, then just click on shading and it will disappear. Then you can go ahead and check it again. Just type out all the characters, and again, it doesn't move. So that's the way in which you ensure that your user can't type and change the form or make the lines go down or make the cell expand and change the form, make it go onto another page by actually dictating how many characters you're allowed to put in that cell. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.